Hey Psych2Goers, and welcome back to another video. For a lot of people, falling in love and finding your soulmate is the ultimate goal in life. And while it would certainly be wonderful to meet the perfect person for you, it definitely doesn't mean that love is all there is to life. But when you make a conscious choice to remain single, oh boy, the battles you have to face then are of a totally different kind. That's because the not-so-single half of the population takes it upon itself to convince you otherwise. What matters is not what everyone else is doing or what other people think you should be doing, but what you want and what's right for you. So with that said, here are 8 things only single people can relate to. 1. Feeling replaced by your friend's significant other. Ever since your friends all started dating someone, do you feel like you hardly see them anymore? You're happy for them, of course, and you try to be as understanding as you can. But there are only so many times they can turn down your invitations or cancel on you at the last minute before you start to feel like you've been abandoned. Everything you used to do with them, they want to do with their significant other now. Like go to the movies or eat at new restaurants. And you can't help but feel the slightest bit of jealousy that this person is now who they want to spend all of their time with. 2, having to be the third wheel all the time. Are you always the third wheel when you hang out with your friends and their partners? Does your friend's significant other tag along on most of your get-togethers now because they want to get to know you better and befriend you too? Which is really nice of them, you have to admit. But it also makes you miss the days when it used to be just you and your friends, and no one felt left out. Sigh. 3, having to stomach a lot of PDA. Whether it's from your friends or couples you see passing by, public displays of affection are honestly uncomfortable for other people to watch. And no, it's not because you're bitter about being single or anything, but after a certain point, it starts to get exhausting. Listening to your friends telling you about all the different reasons why their partner is so dreamy. Having to awkwardly stand around while they kiss and call each other cute pet names. Seeing them act so happy and lovey-dovey all the time. Yeah, no thanks. It might be fun for them, but it's certainly not fun for you to watch and have to stomach it all the time. 4, always being asked why you're still single. Do others badger you relentlessly about why you haven't found someone yet? Do they pressure you into dating again, no matter how many times you tell them you don't want to? From your friends to your relatives to people you barely even know. When you're single for a while, sometimes it feels like that's all anyone wants to talk to you about. You insist that you're single by choice, but most people can't seem to understand why anyone would want to stay single. Oh well. 5, being comforted because of your relationship status. Sad to say, most people just can't seem to wrap their heads around the idea that some of us are actually happy to stay single. A lot of people give us comforting pats on the back whenever the topic comes up and try to encourage us with platitudes like, "Don't worry, it'll happen for you too," or "You'll find someone eventually, just hang in there." As if being single is somehow synonymous with being miserable. 6, being bombarded with personal questions. What happened between you and your ex? Why are you having such a hard time finding someone? Don't you ever get lonely? Is there anyone you like? Once people learn you're still single, they'll start to bombard you with really inappropriate personal questions. They're convinced their questions will help you find your next date. Have you ever thought about dating so-and-so? And of course, isn't it time you moved on already? Single people have to put up with hearing such insensitive questions when, frankly, it's not anyone's business but yours why you choose to stay single. 7, constantly being set up on blind dates. Do people keep coming up to you to say, "I know the perfect match for you," or "You should really meet so-and-so, you'd make a great couple"? If only you had a dollar for every time you heard those things. And while your friends and family members do have good intentions, you can't help but feel fed up over their constant attempts at playing matchmaker and setting you up with someone. And 8, feeling pressured to find someone already. Has anyone ever teased you about being single? Or told you that you should just lower your standards? They make it seem like there's something wrong with being single. But the truth is, you're happy to stay single for now because you know that the journey is every bit as important as the destination. After all, there's a lot of freedom, independence, fun, and excitement that comes from being romantically unattached to someone. In the end, being single allows you to focus on yourself, and it can be a time of great self-growth and self-discovery. It's better to stay single and wait for the right person to come along than settle for anything less. Did you find yourself nodding along to any of these points? Have you seen similar situations in your surroundings? Do let us know in the comments below. Also, remember to like and share this video with others you think might benefit from it. Subscribe to Psych2Go for more videos. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.